All right, it's the main event. We thank you for your gold patronage, and it's great to have them with us. Please, a nice warm welcome for Millie and Noah. Here they go.
Some people get rejected for years and years and then blow up and become biggest stars because they just didn't give up and they just pursued it because they loved it. So that's what I'd say.
Okay, right.
My question is for Noah.
Hi.
Soa or Smelda and why?
So this is a ship name between...
What is it?
This is a ship name. And I would... I ship Soa.
Who's Soa?
This is me and Sid.
Wait, what?
Mood.
Soa?
That's sorry, Millie.
Wait, so you're telling me you're giving up on Millie?
Yeah.
Let's go to the left.
Which cast member did you bond most with?
No, Shrek.
Not Millie. Not, well, I mean, Millie's not a thing, so...
What, no, but it doesn't... Right, you know what, whatever,
Finn.
Yeah, I'll say no, I'll take that. Sorry, Finn, but not. Okay. Alright, so is that it? Oh, amazing. Good question.
Hi, my question is directed towards both of you. So, I know that your friendship is, like, the strongest friendship I've ever seen. And I wanted to, know if the Stranger Things crew maybe put you together in some more scenes, because I know, I heard you talking in an interview about how you and Noah didn't get that many scenes together. Giving as many spoilers away as possible, I don't want you guys to get in trouble.
Yeah, no, I don't want to get in trouble either. That wouldn't be good. I don't know. I can't tell you. Because it's literally, you ask the question, do we have scenes together? But that answer could reflect really badly on the both of us. So I would say I want them to have scenes together. I think Eleven and Will are probably one of the most powerful, like quite literally powerful characters on the show. Just because they actually have somewhat powers. You've been to the Upside Down, I've been to the Upside Down, it's been a whole thing, you can relate. You can share some echoes. How do you know?
You don't like echoes.
I don't like echoes. Eleven loves echoes.
Because
they're so disgusting. They're so bad. No, but I think that we would love
to. I mean, we can't say.
We can't say, but we love to have scenes together. We have had.
We did like, one. Remember when you came into the little tent?
We never had a scene.
What's the tent?
You know,
castle
Bar.
Remember you came into the castle Bar?
Oh, yeah. We could not stop laughing because we're like best friends. And when you're doing a scene with your best friend, it's like all you want to do is crack jokes, inside jokes. Things like that, and like the crew was like, never again. We were just like,
that's what.
Yeah.
left, if any, what ways do you relate with your character?
I mean, you have superpowers.
Are you saying in real life?
What?
I thought that was a compliment.
I was about to blush and I was like, no. No, I'd say probably, I can't relate to 11 at all.
She's such a weirdo. I'm
not weird.
I am weird. That's what we can relate on, I guess. Yeah.
Oh no, maybe she loves people. Like, 11 is a very, she is very closed off, and that's what I'm very closed off. But the people that I genuinely trust and love, that's like my favorite person. You know, so that's what like 11 relates to with like Hopper and Mike and things like that.
I feel like
11
is very touchy. And you're
she's
touchy.
So annoying. She's so, are you saying sensitive?
No, touchy. Like she's very like
affectionate?
No, like touchy. Wanting to touch people. And I relate to Bill because he's
touchy. What do you mean I'm touchy? I'm not affectionate?
No, like touchy. Like I mean,
oh my god, you can talk a little further about that.
And, wait, what was the question? Oh yeah, so
are you touching?
No,
that was the question.
I relate to Bill because he's really close with his brother and I'm really close with my sister.
Aww.
I don't like
her. That's really nice. Chloe would love that. It's really nice. I can't relate, but what side did we just do? Right, it's right now. Hi.
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 Okay, what is your favorite Disney Channel show? And why?
Oh my god.
That's a great question. A genius.
Okay, so I can That's So Raven.
Woo!
I don't actually know, like, I was like probably 6 when I watched that, but it was like just ending, you know? But I would have to say, what is it, Sweet Life?
I never watched it. Everyone did.
Huh?
I never saw it and everyone saw
but
it.
But on deck.
What's the difference?
Well, they were in a hotel, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And now they went on deck.
I like Justin.
Hey, Justin! and the ant farm.
SpongeBob.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
SpongeBob?
I love SpongeBob. But I know it's not Disney.
Gravity Falls.
Yes.
Oh,
Monica.
She just said
TV show though. Hannibal Town.
Yes.
All right.
Who do you look up to and learn from most on set?
I would probably say, this is a really hard one, because like, obviously when I'm a writer, David Harbour, career-wise, like, what they did, like, picking their movies and things like that, they're amazing. But like, looking up to, Joyce Scott, she's really...
Keep
yeah, because I'm like, who do you look up to on the set?
I look up to everyone, you know? Actually not everyone, some people aren't very inspiring.
Oh!
I think...
So bad!
Well, I mean, I look up to most people. I don't know. I look up to everyone.
Some people are inspiring. I would say, I think the teenagers are really good on the show. Natalia Dyer, Joe Keery, Charlie Hayden. They're good. They don't get enough credit for like, but they're really amazing actors. Yeah, amazing people as well.
Alright,
welcome.
What was your favorite scene to film and why?
My favorite was definitely, I think in season one, the very first scene that we filmed, I loved filming because it was just like our first day on set. It was when we were playing D&D, and it was just Our first day on set, and we were all laughing, and we didn't take anything seriously, and we still don't, but it's just, it was just so much fun, and we were just all laughing.
I probably have to say I'm in the scene where I, you know, like, closing the rift. That was cool. Or flipping the band. That was fun.
It's like, good scenes.
I think, yeah, they're all kind of challenging. But especially the scenes where I'm, like, with Hopper. That was the most, like, that was the most fun. Just because David Harbour has a different way of acting. It's more method. So when he's angry, he portrays his anger, you know, things like that, which is amazing. But like when we're off set, we're like looking at each other, really angry. As soon as you go on set, it's like, you are like Papa! Why does she sound Russian? Like, it's like, she's American, 11. She's like, you are like Papa! It's like, it doesn't sound American. It's like,
well, that's your fault.
You are like Papa!
Vote for you.
vote for the category. So I think that's like a lot, like a rewarding part of the show. So yeah, I'd probably say the second one. Also, we've won. So I'll say all the others we lost. So yeah, not the Emmys, because we lost that one. And the Golden Globes. Oh, we can tell this goes on.
This is from Millie. What was it like for you having to make the decision to say your name?
Pretty simple. You know, hair is just hair at the end of the day. It doesn't really define the person you are. Like, long hair can be nice and all that, but like, if you shaved it all off, you'd still be as beautiful as you have had it with hair. So like, personally, it was like for me to show people that like, your beauty isn't everything. And like, just to impress a boy, or to impress your friends, or go to a party. Like, I had to go to a party with a shaved head. All these girls, like amazing hair, and they looked great, and I was just like standing there, like, I looked like a little, like, ET. And, so yeah, so it was fun, though. It was a really fun experience to see my mum's face cry. And I was like, sorry, it's gone. And like, the benefit is that you wash your hair like once every like 3 weeks. Yeah, and when it rains, it's like a massage on your scalp. I really miss it. Should I shave my head again?
Yes.
Yeah. What was your first impression of each other when you guys first met?
I didn't like you.
But I honestly didn't.
But we just didn't like talk.
We just didn't talk to each other.
How did we like meet though? Like, when did we start talking?
It was probably, we went to watch your movie together.
No.
Charlie Brown? Was it Charlie Brown?
No, I don't think we did.
It was Peanuts movie, yeah.
No, but I think we met before that.
Oh, we met before that, but we didn't get like... We like... I don't think... He was just very outgoing. Oh, no, you weren't outgoing. You were very shy. You didn't speak to
anyone. Yeah, Caleb told me that when I met Caleb, he said I ran away from him.
And we are a powerful friendship now. Dad, put your phone on silent.
It's fun.
Oh, okay. It's my mom. yeah, so probably.
So when did we meet?
I don't know. I mean, we obviously met.
Well, like,
we did bike train.
It just happened, you know? Like, no one ever says, like, can we be friends? And then they say, yes, it just happened.
Yeah. That we just started to miss each other when, like, because he was not in many scenes. In the first season, he definitely made up for that in the second, because it's kind of amazing in the second season. But the first season, he wasn't, he just kept leaving, going back to New York, and coming back, and back to New York. So I was like, where is Noah? And then everybody was like, why do you miss Noah? I was like, because he's my best friend. It's like a scene from it was because he's my best friend, I have to admit it. And then he came back, and yeah, then we had a sleepover together, and it was a whole thing. We watched Blackfish, remember that? In the tent, in my house.
We watched Love Island.
Oh my god, Love Island. So good. Okay, next.
This is for Noah, and what was it like being on the first episode of Life on Demand?
Oh, that was really cool. She's really sweet. I love her. She's like so bubbly and just small, and she smells great, and she's a great person just all around, and I had so much fun with her, and I got to curse finally, and it was a lot of fun.
Would you rather have 11 or 8 power in real life? Who is this to? Because I would answer. Honestly, 8 power, just because, like, if I was like, mum, like, I didn't do it, I'm just looking into her eyes, and she'll be like, if I said, like, she was like, who stole my eyebrow pencil? I could be like, I didn't do it. And she'd be like, okay. And she'd walk away instead of being like, I know you did it! You know?
Yeah, but what about,
avoids
like,
a whole argument.
What about if, like, you're in bed and there's,
and
like, something over there?
To charge up.
Yeah. And you just want to be like, like, that's so much better. You don't even have to get out of bed. That's fine.
Yeah. So you're going to go for 11 to pounds? Oh, what compliment. All right. Hello.
Hi.
What was the hardest scene in the film?
I mean, for me, it was in season two, I mean, I had a couple of them. It was, one of them was in episode 9 when the monster was coming out of me, and it was, we filmed all night, and it was like 4 in the morning, 5 in the morning, and I was just so tired, but I was like screaming, and they just kept feeding me like cups of tea, and I was just screaming all night, and I was just so tired, but it turned out great, I think, so.
It turned out amazing, right?
And then I think the seizure, I had to do a seizure, and then definitely in episode 3 or 4, I think it was with Winona, when I was telling her about what happened in the field.
That was good. When you was like, wait, you're like tapping the foot. That was so good, that was in the trailer. That was really good. Didn't like Sean have to tell you to like, he was like, cry.
He was like, we did a take and it was like coming, and then they cut and it like just came, and then they're like, and then they like restarted, and then I got it.
It worked. And probably the scene where I closed the rift, just because I was fed in cups of tea too, because I was screaming so much. And then when I fell to the ground, right, see.
Hi, Noah, how do you manage to get stuck in a chair?
That's
a great question.
I mean, you know, it happens to the best of us. Sometimes we just... I when I'm sitting, I can't... Like, right now, I have to sit just right like this, because there's no opening in the back, but sometimes I like to change it up and move the chair around, so I'll like sit on this side and just move around. One time I got stuck in a seatbelt and my mom had to like drive to CVS and get scissors and cut that out of it. It just happens to me, I get stuck in things.
Because he's gotten stuck in more than once.
No, that's what's funny. Is
I mean, it happens to everyone.
No, it doesn't. I hope you know, like, please tell me nobody else has gotten stuck in a chair. You got stuck in a chair.
My friend put me in a chair and I got stuck in a chair.
Good for you.
The only thing I've been stuck in is in a cinema chair.
How?
Because you know when you sit down, I was going to the bathroom and I sat back down and I, like, what do you think? That's not really a chair, that's like a horrible place to be.
Which way do we go?
Okay. Hi. Who's an actor or an actress you'd like to work with in the future?
No. Go ahead.
Oh. Well.
I'm zoning. I work with the fire, okay?
I've said this before, but I'd love to work with Tom Holland. I think he's a great actor.
Oh, that's good. That's a good one. Dad, who do you think? Yeah. Because I forget. Jessica's Jessica.
Oh, wasn't she part of the game yesterday?
She was part. We were playing a board game yesterday, and like, we had to be like, name an actor that begins with the letter M. And I was like, Billy Bob Brown! And I was like, okay. And he was like, name an actor who's been in an animated movie. And he was like, no shit! I was like, oh my god, you're like terrible ones. Okay, which side? This
one. Okay, hi. This is for Noah. How was it, like, being in a Panic at the Disco video?
Oh, that was really cool. I mean, I got to meet Brendan Urie, and he's like the nicest guy. I mean, I love him. He's like, he's very, like, I don't know what the word is, but he's just, and he's just so cool. I loved working with him, and I met him twice. I got to go on stage with him too for a bit. And I mean, it was a lot of fun. I love the video too. Yeah.
So,
next one.
Hi, this question is for Millie. I was wondering how you find it to go from British to American accents. Is there anything you especially do to, you know, speak in an American accent or British, or does it just come naturally?
No, it just comes naturally. There's like different places in America.
because they speak a little bit different from each other. Like, it's like totally California. It's like really annoying. And then you have like Southern. I love the Southern accent. I live in Georgia, so it's like my favorite thing to hear when they're like, well, how there, really? And I'm like, but yeah, no, it's really easy to just go in and out of it. It's like, Eleven has a pretty basic American accent. I don't really know, where was she born? That's a question. I don't even know what accent she would, but listen, she's part Russian. I don't know how she got that, but part Russian. Her mom hasn't spoken yet, so maybe she's Russian. There you go.
Oh, sorry. What's the strangest thing a fan has ever said to you?
What's the strangest thing a fan has ever said to you?
The strangest thing
a fan has said to you?
I mean, it has to be PG.
Okay, yeah, don't say it.
Fans say some crazy things.
Yeah, they do. None of you guys, I'm not saying it's specific, but like, I think there's just very passionate people that are very interesting. Say interesting. Because people think that like we're like 45, so they feel like they can say anything to us. But like, no, we're like really silly, and like if you say something that's gonna make us like burst out laughing, we will burst out laughing. So I feel like people, no, but when people say something to us, it's like they think we're like, we will just get it. Don't. Like, do you know what I'm saying? People like talk to us like we're adults, basically. And sometimes it just comes out weird to us because we're younger. But I would have to say somebody said to me once, maybe not. It's really interesting. I just, yeah, people
married
like tell
to a couple people.
Oh, somebody proposed to me once. That was weird.
Oh, I saw a YouTube video of some guys and
husband. And I said, yeah, he came up to the stage. I was like, will you marry me? I said no, but I said I'll take the ring. I did take the ring. I still have it. Very nice ring. Yeah, God bless them.
I mean, it was definitely, I remember I sent in a self-tape, I think, a while back. That was like 9 or 10 or something. And, or no, I was 10. And I sent it in, and it was, I was kind of tired, and I was like, eh, this is gonna go nowhere. And then I sent it in, and I got a call back, and they called me back a couple more times, and they started forming. Well, I originally auditioned for Mike, so I was doing lines with Mike and stuff, and then I remember we did, later on we met each other in LA. Well, I didn't meet you, but I met Caleb. In LA. And we just met, like, they narrowed it down to a few people for each role, and we were all meeting each other, and everyone was, like, giving each other looks.
Oh, yeah, that was really cool. Yeah. The girl who was going for 11 and never given someone the dirtiest look was like, this is my role. Yeah, I went in there with Finn and then this other boy. So I went in with this other boy, and he was, like, standing there. He was like, I don't know my lines. And I was like, wow. And then Finn came in, he was like, everything, you know exactly what to do, and I was like, there you go! Like, we happened to have like the best chemistry ever. So it was amazing. And then this other girl came in with Finn and the other boy, and I was like, looking at Scott, she was like long hair, and she was really pretty, and I was like, based on looks, you are beautiful, but I don't really know. And then the next day they were like, well, do you want us to be your Eleven? And I was like, and it's never been the best thing to like get a job after like thousands of no's. So it was amazing though. I mean, the first that we had on set was like we all like discussed, did you audition with this guy? Did you audition with that girl? And then we all came to
Rosie.
That was our crazy teacher. Okay.
I miss her.
You don't.
Definitely. She was a little like pink pad. She was so cute.
Ideal role be?
Sorry, we can still be the same.
I'll just be Carrie Fisher too. I mean, there's so many cool things to like be a part of. I'd love to be. I've always wanted to be. When I saw Jeremy Hansen, I wanted to be part of that. But I mean, I was gonna say Star Wars.
Can you guys cry on cue when you do your scene?
Sorry?
Can you cry on cue when you do your scene?
Yeah. It's kind of awkward to say yes to that. It's like, oh yeah, I can.
Yeah, I know,
it's
right?
Like, I can. Just because we practice a lot. Like, I'd be in my bedroom, look in the mirror, start crying. You do that?
Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm not the only one.
I love crying.
I love crying. No, it's
and when
really...
other people are crying and you're hugging them and crying and they're
like, oh my god,
like,
yeah.
Aww.
Like, it's so, oh my god. It's so satisfying to cry and see when one tear falls down and you don't even move. So I love crying. It's my favorite. Also, it comes in handy if you're having a stop.
No, I'm not.
You're crying.
No, I'm not.
Maybe we're trying.
No,
it's just
no, I was just thinking.
Oh, okay. You have to drink a lot of water though.
Yeah, that's right.
Water. Because, like, it's like draining. Especially, okay, not to like, I'm not like being like big headed or anything. I'm just saying, like, this is what I can do. Like, I can like control my tears to like out of which eye. So, like, continuity wise, the directors love it because we can like.
And then you can like drive them. Like,
yeah, you can drive them. Move your cheek just a little
bit. Yeah, you can make them go like that way or that
and
way.
Like, or when you're laying down.
Yeah. Like, oh, sideways. I love that.
So good. Oh, there's no people left. Okay, do you have a question? I have a question for you now.
Well, I have a question for you.
Okay, go ahead. I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay. What's your favorite color?
Purple. Who's your best friend?
Maybe no.
Yeah. Okay, so I guess that's the end, but I guess it's the end, right? Okay, so thank you guys so much for coming.